In PowerPoint, you have the ability to link to a web page, email address, file, or a slide. You can do all of this using two tools called hyperlinks and action buttons. Let's take a look at how hyperlinks work. After the orientation, all the employees will receive an electronic copy of these slides. I want to insert a new slide that includes a list of resources for the new employees. Some of these resources are websites. I can insert a hyperlink on this slide that will link to a website. A hyperlink is a connection from one slide to a web page, email address, slide, or file. Text or an object, such as a picture or shape, can be used as a hyperlink. To insert a hyperlink, first select the text or object that you want to use. In this case, I want this text to be the hyperlink or connection to the website, so I'll just select it. Then, select the Insert tab. In the Links group, click the Hyperlink command. This opens the Insert Hyperlink dialog box. If you're using text, at the top you'll see a Text to Display field that is active. The text we selected on the slide appears there. On the left of the dialog box, you'll see four options: Existing File or Web Page, Place in this Document, Create New Document, and Email Address. I want this text to connect to a web page, so I'll leave that selected. Now, in the Address field, I need to enter the website address that I want to display when the link is clicked. So I'll just type www.gcflearnfree.org. Once you've entered the web address, decide whether you want a screen tip to appear when you hover over the hyperlink. Screen tips are the little boxes of text that appear when you hover over a command. The tips provide directions or explain more about the command. If you do want to insert a screen tip, just click Screen Tip and a small dialog box appears. Just enter the text you want to appear as the tip. Once you've entered your text, click OK and then click OK in the Insert Hyperlink dialog box. If you're working with text, click anywhere on the slide to deselect the text so you can see the hyperlink. Since we are using text right now, you'll notice that hyperlinked text is displayed underlined and in a color that coordinates with the color scheme. If you are using an object hyperlink, it won't have additional formatting. In PowerPoint, hyperlinks become active when you run the presentation, so let's select Slideshow View. As you move the pointer toward the hyperlink, it becomes a hand. This indicates that this is something you can click. This is especially useful if you're using an object like a picture or shape as a hyperlink. As you hover over the hyperlink, a screen tip will appear if you entered one. Just click the hyperlinked text to open the web page if you are connected to the internet. As I mentioned, you can insert a hyperlink to another slide in this presentation. At AdWorks, managers have books and other offline resources that they can lend to employees. I may want to insert a hyperlink here that connects to our organization chart. To do this, select the text or object you wish to use as a hyperlink, and then click the hyperlink command on the Insert tab. The Insert Hyperlink dialog box appears. Click Place in this document since we want to link to another slide. When you do this, the dialog box will change, and you'll see a box with the list of the slides in your presentation. You'll also see a more generic listing of the slides, such as first slide, last slide, and next slide. As you click a slide, a thumbnail image of it will appear in the slide preview area. Select the slide you wish to link to, which in this case is slide 6, our organization slide. If you want to include a screen tip, you can add that now. And once you are ready, just click OK. If you are working with text, you can see the hyperlink on the slide. Let's take a look at it in slideshow view. When we click this hyperlink, the organization slide will appear. See, adding hyperlinks is not difficult at all. I'll just press Escape to return to normal view. I mentioned before that you can link to a file. Let's say I want to link to a presentation about financial and retirement planning. This hyperlink works just the same as the two we've already looked at. Once you have selected the text or object you want to use as a hyperlink, you can open the Insert Hyperlink dialog box. If I wanted to, I could create a new document and link to it, but honestly, I never use this option. I'll let you explore this option on your own. I'm actually going to select existing file or web page. In the center, I have all the tools I need to locate the file. The file I need is right here on my desktop, so I'll just select it. You'll notice that the file name appears in the address field. Click the bookmark button and a dialog box appears. From here, you need to select the slide in your financial planning presentation that you want to link to, and then click OK. If you have a screen tip to enter, you can do that now. Then click OK to close the Insert Hyperlink dialog box. If you go to Slideshow View and click the hyperlink, the slide we bookmarked in our financial planning slide show will appear. Knowing how to hyperlink files, slides, web pages, and email addresses can be quite convenient during a slideshow presentation. Try it out for yourself to see how simple it is to create hyperlinks.